something strange is occurring at Ethiopia's Fentale Volcano, and we aren't exactly sure what is happening there. In merely a week, what was before the dry and largely barren volcanic floor of its deep caldera has either been rapidly filled by an up to 70-meter or 226.4-foot deep lake that is nearly a kilometer in size, or there is no new lake but instead an ever-expanding volume of volcanic gas. Satellite imagery, both low and high resolution, shows an ever-expanding bright white region within the Fentale Volcano's caldera since January 15th, perhaps with hints of it as early as January 12th, and this unknown feature is still expanding at the present. I initially interpreted this white material to be rising volcanic gas associated with shallow magma that contained minor amounts of sulfur dioxide, with multiple videos soon after being published by locals who self-reported and showed footage of a very faint blue-tinted rising gas plume. However, while the plume in this video footage did indeed contain minor amounts of sulfur dioxide, later geolocation proved that these videos merely showed a human-set wildfire associated with clearing land for agriculture. So, why don't we just send a person, or preferably a drone, up to the top of the Fentale Volcano to get a true sense of what is occurring? After all, there are 23,000 people in the adjacent city of Medahara. You'd think this would be an easy mystery to solve. However, two major problems. The first problem is that the Fentale Volcano is considered too dangerous to climb at the present alongside regional evacuation orders. Also, you might have noticed that there are geologists and volcanologists in the region which work for the Ethiopian government whom are actively performing analysis of the developing situation. At least, they are in the northern half of the magma dike extent only, including the numerous mud volcanoes and hydrothermal explosion craters which repeatedly formed near the Dauphin volcano. You might have also seen footage of armed military guards next to TV crews reporting on the situation. These guards are not simply there to protect from dangerous wild animals that live in the region such as lions, leopards, and hyenas. Instead, they are primarily there to protect TV crews in a region that is currently in a state of armed conflict. To the south, in and around the city of Medahara, right next to the Fentale Volcano where all of this is occurring, social media footage seemingly showed a significant armed rebel presence as of one day ago. While I cannot confirm that these rebels are causing any problems with the TV crews or geologists, the key point is that both of these count as government workers. And they are allegedly not allowed at the present to get close to rebel-held areas for what was cited to me simply as security reasons. Therefore, we are unlikely to discover what is truly ongoing within the summit area of the Fentale Volcano anytime soon, with us only being able to rely upon social media reports and satellite imagery. Sorry for that bit of geopolitics, I am not making a personal statement on my feelings of the ongoing war or parties to the conflict in the region, just I thought it was important to understand why geologists and volcanologists haven't simply walked up the volcano and just looked down to simply solve this mystery. So, what does the satellite data show us? Whatever this white material is, it seems to be primarily composed of water, although it does not form a super strong match with nearby pre-existing bodies of water. For reference, the vast, vast majority of a volcanic gas plume, whether from an eruption plume or fumarole, is composed of water vapor. So, while this theory could fit, locals in Medahara have not reported a rising gas plume or weird smell of any kind that would represent the presence of sulfur dioxide or hydrogen sulfide. However, if these gases are volcanic, then portions of them are heavier than air and thus remaining close to the ground and simply pooling in low-lying locations, expanding in volume every day since they aren't dissipating due to wind. But what about the crater lake theory, with a white either representing a white or milky colored water body and or the steam rising from said water? This theory, suggested initially by the Extreme Pursuit YouTube channel, actually seems to have far stronger evidence in my opinion and is more likely to be correct than my prior initial hypothesis of volcanic gas emissions. Satellite shows the bright white material not only appearing in local minimas within the caldera, but also from cracks that represent drainages on its inner caldera walls. This would make sense since the Fentale volcano has been experiencing subsidence lately, meaning magma shouldn't be too shallow there. With subsidence forming fractures, these could allow heated groundwater a path to the surface, explaining why such a large lake formed so quickly. So, what does this mean in terms of the volcanic eruption hazard if this theory is correct? It could be a sign of shallow magma heating deep groundwater or just be subsidence related. The truth is, we do not know. However, volcanic and seismic activity does seem to be decreasing overall, but our inability to figure out what this new white spot on satellite is hinders our ability to properly analyze the ongoing volcanic unrest. For example, if the white mass is water, it could be highly acidic, and its composition and pH could tell us if shallow magma is present there.